what is a gram-positive bacteria? A gram-positive bacteria is a bacteria that gives a positive result in a gram stain. So in a gram stain test, it gives a positive result. So this staining is being used for classifying the bacteria into two broad categories. And this two broad categories is based on the cell wall. So based on the cell wall, a bacteria can be classified into two. When we do a gram stain test, so we get based on two, that is based on the positive results, we can say that it is gram positive bacteria, and the negative result gives the gram negative bacteria. So a gram positive bacteria is a bacteria that gives a positive result in staining with gram stain. So a crystal violet stain is taken up by the gram positive bacteria, and this bacteria gives a purple color when it is observed under optical microscope. So when under an optical microscope, the gram positive bacteria takes up the crystal violet and gives a purple color. So this is because of the peptidoglycan layer present in the cell wall. So because of the presence of peptidoglycan layer, after the decolorization step, the crystal violet still appears in the peptidoglycan layer, which gives it a purple color. So a gram positive bacteria is purple colored due to the presence of peptidoglycan layer in a cell wall of a gram positive bacteria. A gram negative bacteria also has this peptidoglycan layer, but this peptidoglycan layer is much thinner than the gram positive. So gram negative also has the peptidoglycan layer, but it's much thinner comparatively with the gram positive bacteria. And this layer is sandwiched between the inner cell membrane and outer membrane. So the peptidoglycan layer is present between inner and outer membranes of the bacteria. And hence, they take the counter stain, that is the counter stain that is being used in a gram staining. And hence, a bacteria appears red or pink in color. This diagram would help you understand the difference in the structure of a gram-negative as well as the gram-positive bacteria. A gram-positive bacteria only has a cytoplasmic membrane, and the peptidoglycan layer is much thick in a gram-positive bacteria, whereas in a gram-negative bacteria, it has an outer membrane as well as an inner membrane. The peptidoglycan layer is very thin in a gram-negative bacteria. So, this is the basic difference in the structure of the cell wall of gram-negative and a gram-positive bacteria. By using a gram staining, a gram-positive bacteria appears purple color, whereas a gram-negative bacteria takes up red or a pink color. So a gram-positive bacteria can be differentiated into different types based on their shape. So it can be classified into three broad categories based on shape. It is bacilli, cocci, and branching filaments. So a bacilli as well as a branching filament appears in aerobic as well as anaerobic bacteria. So in bacilli, both aerobic and anaerobic bacteria are present. For example, of aerobic bacteria is bacillus, and an anaerobic bacterium is clostridium. So a cocci is always aerobic bacteria. Example is staphylococcus and streptococcus. A branching filament can be aerobic as well as anaerobic. An example of aerobic is nocardia, and an example for anaerobic is actinomyces. This diagram shows the examples of gram-positive bacteria. They include Staphylococcus aureus, Streptococcus, Clostridium, etc. Today, we will discuss about gram-positive cell wall. A prokaryote has a capsule and a cell membrane. Between the capsule and cell membrane, there is a layer called cell wall. And this cell wall is made up of peptidoglycan. That is the major component of a cell wall is peptidoglycan. And this gives the cell wall its shape and the strength. This diagram is the ultrastructure of a bacterial cell. A bacterial cell outermost layer is a capsule, and inside the capsule there is a layer called cell wall. And after the cell wall is a plasma membrane. So a prokaryotic cell has a cell wall between a capsule and a plasma membrane. The cell wall is made up of disaccharides, that is, it is made up of two sugar derivatives. First is N-acetyl glucose amine and the second is N-acetyl muramic acid. So the two sugar derivatives, that is N-acetyl glucose amine and N-acetyl muramic acid, is joined together by a short peptide chain. So the N-acetyl muramic acid carries a tetrapeptide side chain, that is, it consists of D-glutamic acid and L-alanine. And for the Gram native, along with them, they have a mesodiamino pinealic acid. And for Gram positive, they have L-lysine. So the tetrapeptide side chains are interconnected by pentaglycine bridges. So most of the Gram native cell walls lack this interpeptide bridges. So the purpose of a cell wall in a bacteria is to provide the shape and to protect the bacteria from osmotic pressure. A bacteria can be differentiated into two types, gram-positive bacteria and gram-negative bacteria. This classification is done based on the structural difference of gram-positive and gram-negative cell walls. So the cell wall of a gram-positive bacteria is simpler, whereas the gram-negative bacteria is more complex in the chemical structures. So the cell wall of a gram-positive bacteria is more thick, as well as it's more homogeneous than a thin gram-negative bacteria. So a gram-positive cell wall contains more amount of peptidoglycan, and it contains about 40 to 80% of the dry weight of the cell wall. This gram-positive cell wall consists of two layers, that is, teichoic acid and citronic acid. These two components account up to 50% of the dry weight of the wall and 10% of the dry weight of the total cell. So, a gram-positive cell wall is made up of citronic acid and teichoic acid. What is this teichoic acid? These teichoic acids are polymers of polyribitol or polyglycerol phosphate. So, they are the polymers of polyribitol or polyglycerol phosphates, and they contain ribitol and glycerol. Along with them, they also have carbohydrates, and these are linked by a phosphodiester bond. The teichoic acid are of two types, that is LTA and WTA. LTA is lipoteichoic acid, and they are teichoic acid that are anchored to the lipid membrane. So the teichoic acids that are anchored to the lipid membrane is LTA, whereas the teichoic acids that are covalently bound to the peptidoglycan layer is volteichoic acid or WTA. So the teichoic acids are of two types, LTA and WTA. LTA is lipoteichoic acid and WTA is volteichoic acid. So the citronic acid is the repeated unit of sugar acids, that is, they are the repeated units of N-acetyl muramic acid or D-glucuronic acid. So they are synthesized when the phosphate supply to the cell is limited. So when the phosphate supply to the cell is limited, the tetraonic acid is being produced. And the gram-positive bacteria has neutral sugars as well as acidic sugars. So the neutral sugars are mannose, arabinose, etc. Whereas the acidic sugars are glucuronic acid, mannuronic acid, etc. And these are the subunits for the polysaccharides in the cell wall. This diagram is a detailed structure of a gram-positive bacteria cell wall. A gram-positive bacteria cell wall consists of a thick peptidoglycan layer. This peptidoglycan layer is a polymer of sugar as well as amino acids. The sugar components are alternating residues of N-acetyl glucose amine and N-acetyl muramic acid. So these sugars are alternating residues of NAM, that is N-acetyl muramic acid, which are the green circles, and N-acetyl glucose amine, which are the orange circles. They are found alternating. So the amino acids are found attached to the NAM, that is N-acetyl muramic acids. The teichoic acids are of two types, that is the voltteichoic acid and the lipoteichoic acid. The lipoteichoic acids are found attached to the lipid layer of the cell membrane, whereas the voltteichoic acids are found attached to the peptidoglycan layer, and they are attached to the peptidoglycan layer by covalent bonds. Hope you understood the concept of a gram-positive cell wall. So, for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel. If you like the video, please like as well as share with your friends.